students, I shall discuss the module number 2 in 18 MAT DIP 41. This is lecture 1. We shall study the topic on numerical analysis. This numerical analysis topic is a branch of mathematics which consists of the following contents. Let me mention the contents, afterwards one by one I shall discuss. In this numerical analysis, the first topic is introduction, and next is finite differences of various orders, finite differences of various orders. We need to discuss about the symbols, that is forward and backward. And next is interpolation. This is Newton's forward interpolation formula and Newton's backward interpolation formula. There are two formulas you have to discuss in this. Then solution of algebraic transcendental equations, in this two methods are there. One is regular proxy method, and another one is Newton-Raphson method. And the next topic is numerical integration. In this numerical integration, we study only the two important concepts. One is Simpson's rule and trapezoidal rule, sorry, Weddell's rule. There are two formulas in this we have to study under the numerical integration. The first topic is introduction, next is finite differences of various orders, and next is interpolation. There are two types of interpolation formulas. One is Newton's forward interpolation formula and the other one is Newton's backward interpolation formula. And the next is solution of algebraic transcendental equations. And in that, there are two methods we have to discuss. And the next topic is numerical integration, where we need to discuss about Simpson's 1/3 and Simpson's 3/8. There are two formulas due to Simpson's. And one more is Weddell's difference formula. These things will come in integration of numerical analysis formulas. So let me start with one by one. Let me give the brief introduction of this numerical analysis. What we know so far, you have been studying the calculations using logarithm table and the calculator and the computer. If you observe these three systems, let me write those things. Calculation, this is first is using log table, it is a book, and next one is calculator, and next one is computer. Why I am writing these three? Because already you are familiar with the logarithm table. It's a small book, and that book also can be used. Maybe it's around costing about something like around 50 rupees. And next is calculator. that is FX120 if you want, then this may cost around 700 rupees. And this computer may cost about around 50,000 rupees. See why we need these different calculation procedures. So only 50 rupees is enough to give the calculations. Why to go for 700 rupees and then 50,000 rupees? Okay, then so 50 rupees, 700 rupees and 50,000 rupees means why we have to go for all these higher investments, that means more investment of the money. The reason is very simple. Here in the logarithm table, you are going to work out after the point, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the decimal place you are going to work out, not more than this. In the logarithm table, you are already familiar. In that logarithm table, only 4 decimal places you are going to write the calculation. But in this calculator, you are going to write after the point 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, even up to 8 is common, 9, 10, up to 10 digits you can calculate. Whereas in this computer, after the point you are going to work out 1, 2, 3, up to 69 decimal places, 68 or 69 decimal places presently in the IBM system. That is, the difference you can see, the difference is here after the point 4 decimal places, and in this computer after the point, that is 8 or 10 decimal places, and in the computer that is up to 69 decimal places. So in all these three cases, the purpose of using the calculator, logarithm table and the computer is that the secrecy of the mathematics lies when you increase the number of decimal places, the degree of accuracy in any calculation goes on increasing. Here it works up to only 4 decimal places because your answer you have to wind up to 4 decimal places. Whereas in this case you are going to wind up to, that is, 8 or 10 decimal places using your pocket calculator. And in this computer it is designed minimum of 69 decimal places. Now they are enhancing it even up to 120 also you can calculate. So see the beauty of it. That is up to this much, 4 decimal places, but we are completely missing the approximation or the accuracy after the 4th decimal places, that is 5th, 6th, 7th and so on. Here after the 10th decimal places, 11th, 12th and so on, that much of accuracy is not accumulated in the previous calculation. And here also, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 when you write, the accuracy from 5th decimal place, 7th, 6th decimal place and 7th decimal place and so on, that part we are going to completely miss out. Then here also, even if it is working up to 120, you can see that if any of the latest version gives more than that, still it is most welcome. Therefore, the beauty of this numerical analysis is nothing but numerical analysis means the word numerical says is approximately equal to. So in whichever the calculation we are not able to reach the required degree of accuracy in any calculation, we are going near to the actual value or true value of that particular approximation. That is the beauty of this numerical analysis. Therefore, we need to write 4 decimal places, 8 decimal places and 10 decimal places. Then we have to work out the calculations using the number of decimal places more, so that you will be getting more accurate value. That is the beauty and that is the most secret point. So in that, some of the topics you have to understand, some of the formulations you have to understand. Those formulations are nothing but, first is solution of system solution of equations where those equations are containing other than polynomial terms, like polynomial terms means ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. That equation will be called as, that is called as second degree equation, otherwise quadratic equation. Thereby we know the roots of the quadratic equation, that is x equal to minus b plus minus root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Then in that equation, if we come across other than the polynomial terms, even higher degree polynomial terms, x cube, x to the power of 4, x to the power of 5, even e to the power x sin x, then exponential term, even sin hyperbolic x, cos hyperbolic x, tan x, secant x, and log x, like that. See, all these terms when we come across, so we don't have any ready procedure in order to find out the roots of the equations. Then we need to go for the approximation using numerical techniques. So those numerical techniques will be called as methods to solve the transcendental equations. Such are the terms in any equation we come across, that equation is called transcendental equation. Those terms such as trigonometric, hyperbolic, exponential, log function, even higher degree polynomials, they are all called as transcendental terms. Then any equation contains such of the terms is called transcendental equation. Thereby we need to solve such different simple equations using these numerical methods, but we cannot solve those equations by any other method. This is solution of algebraic transcendental equations. And then interpolation, the next chapter is interpolation. Okay, so anyway, the degree of accuracy goes on increasing when you go for number of decimals more. This is the most secret point, main purpose of studying this numerical in whichever the field you are going to apply. This has got a wider application. This will be applied in solving, in the previous class we studied as matrix equations. There also system of linear equations we studied. There also we apply numerical technique. And next is to solve the differential equations also we apply these numerical methods. And to solve the partial differential equations and to solve all the higher degree equations and complicated polynomial equations, we need to find the values of the roots, values of x, whichever the symbol is given as a root of the equation, then we apply these numerical techniques. Now, let me go for the first topic in the introduction. Linear operators. Some notations we are going to use in this numerical analysis, that is called forward difference operator, backward difference operator, shifting operator, differential operator, like that. There are so many symbols are there, but only for the present discussion, how many symbols we want, those notations only I am going to mention in the today's lecture. Linear operators, the definition is like this. Linear operators are those which operate on the function f of x give the following results. First one, E, shifting operator. Shifting operator. E. What is this? E operates on f of x. You do not read E into fx. This is an operator symbol. You need to use E operates on the function, that is f of x.
that is equal to f of x plus h minus of it is f of x. Here h is spacing between two values of x, two successive values of x, this is you have to write as the h value. This is called shifting operator. This is only e of fx is equal to f of x plus h. This is called shifting operator. One increment will be given, that is h means that is nothing but delta x. Delta x equal to h, that is nothing but, for example, x naught and x 1 and x 2. This h is the spacing. It is equal, that is x 3. Here this is also h, like that. It is equally divided. H is common. Otherwise, it is called one increment, that is displacement on the x axis. So between any two successive values of x, successive values means x naught, x 1, two successive values, x 1, x 2, two successive values, otherwise x 2, x 3 are the next two successive values. This is called the shifting operator. Second one, forward difference operator. Forward difference operator. This is triangle shape. We call this is called forward difference operator delta. We call it as delta when delta operates on the function f of x plus h and minus of fx. F of x plus h minus of fx is called forward difference operator. The function which takes, you don't read this one as delta into. The function delta operates on the function, takes one increment and minus of original function. This is called forward difference operator. Next, backward difference operator. Backward difference operator. This is reverse direction, that is delta. This delta operates on the function f of x is equal to, that is f of x minus f of x minus h. This is one value towards positive direction. If this is x naught, this is x 1, this is x 2, this is h and this is h, and here x minus 1 and x minus 2, this is also h, this is also h. Delta operates on that is f of x is equal to one value earlier. This you have to write in the reverse order, but f of x minus h. This was in the preceding values of x, but earlier one was measured towards the succeeding values of x. That this is going to be measured in terms of preceding values. Preceding means previous values. Then this is delta of fx is called the backward difference operator. Next one is differential operator, dfx. Already you are familiar, this differential operator is nothing but derivative. D by dx operates on fx is equal to f dash of x, otherwise dy by dx. Like this, some of the operators are there, but mainly we are going to use this operator and this operator. But this one, f of x plus h, you can write it as this one, e fx minus of fx, because e fx is f of x plus h. This quantity you can replace by this quantity. Okay, then delta fx is equal to e fx minus f of x. That is nothing but fx you can take common, that is e minus 1, it is f of x. this is operated.
So e minus 1 is not a coefficient, e minus 1 is the number which is
before the function. Then here delta f of x is equal to
e minus 1 operates on fx. Then
you can compare one relation here, this delta is equal to e minus 1. Delta is equal to e minus 1, this gives e is equal to 1 plus delta.
This is what you will find in the standard textbooks, the relation between shifting operator and the
forward difference operator. The relation between shifting operator means this one, capital E, and forward difference operator means delta, so that e is equal to 1 plus delta.
This is the theoretical background before I use these operators. Okay,
then next part of this you have to understand finite differences of various orders
according to your syllabus. This part you have to study, and then finite differences of various orders. I shall explain only the forward and backward differences. Based on this, two important equations I am going to mention. As per your syllabus, derivations are not there. Only we have to apply these formulas on the given table of values.
The next heading on this numerical analysis topic is finite differences of various orders.
Finite differences of various orders. Here, forward difference and backward difference will be operated on separately, will be operated on certain set of values. Certain set of values means values as usual from the functional relation, that is y is equal to f of x, which takes x takes the values x0, x1, x2, x3 and so on, and y takes the values y0, y1, y2, y3 and so on, like that. Then we shall consider how these of operators, forward difference operator and backward difference operator, can be applied, and how these differences are going to explain on the right side what are the values and what are the corresponding notations that we are going to understand.
Let y is equal to f of x be the function takes the set of points x naught, y naught, x1, y1, x2, y2 and so on, through which the graph of
the function
y is equal to f of x passes through.
The graph of the function y is equal to f of x passes through.
Therefore, these are the set of points x0, y0, x1, y1, x2, y2 and so on, where this is our original function, such that we define the finite difference. The finite differences of various orders as follows.
Finite differences of various orders as follows. I will define only two symbols, that is forward and backward, as per your syllabus.
Okay. The first one, forward differences and second one backward differences. Forward differences using delta, backward differences using it is reverse delta.
So this is forward difference operator and the another one is backward difference operator.
Then here it is first one forward difference operator, let me discuss. Okay, then y1 minus y0 is equal to delta y0.
Next value of y column, y in the y column, next, that means second value of y minus of first value of y, the difference is indicated with the second term symbol, that is last term symbol suffix will be represented along with this difference operator. That is forward difference operator. It is called first order forward differences and the first value. This is called first order forward differences and the first value. Similarly,
y2 minus y1 is equal to delta y1. Next is y3 minus y2 is equal to delta y2 and so on. Are called first order forward differences.
First order forward differences. So these are only between two successive values of y. Okay, now
first order forward difference means delta to the power 1, delta to the power 1 and delta to the power 1.
These are called first order forward differences.
The next one, that is y2 minus 2y1 plus y0. Otherwise, let me write in the reverse order. Delta 2y0 is equal to apply for this delta, that is delta of delta y naught is equal to delta is applied y1 minus y naught. Okay, operate delta on both sides. As a result, delta 2y naught is equal to delta operates on delta y naught is equal to delta y1 minus of delta y naught. Okay, then what is delta y1 and delta y0? This is equal to delta y1 minus of delta y0. So this gives, what is first one? Delta y1 is y2 minus, it is y1 minus of y1 minus, it is y0. So according to these notations, already first order we have defined, and from those first order differences we have written, and this is coming to be y2, this is y1 minus y1, 2y1, and this is minus into minus plus, only once appeared, this is y0. This is called delta 2 y0.
So this is called first value of second order forward difference. Otherwise,
second order forward difference, first value. And similarly, delta 2, if you take the next suffix, delta 2y1 is equal to, that should be according to this order. This is 2, 1, 0, when 0 is there. There must be three values. Last symbol, whatever suffix is there will come as, that is forward difference operator notation. Then this is equal to it should be y3 minus 2 times y2 and plus y1, because y1 is there,
this should be the last symbol.
Then delta 2 y1 is equal to y3 minus 2 y2 plus of y1 etc. are called second order forward differences. Second order forward differences. Similarly, the next one, delta 3 y0 is equal to, one more time delta you operate, that is delta on this delta 2 y0. Delta should be operated on delta square, you will be getting delta cube. What is this? Whatever the expression is there, you apply that. Delta of already delta 2 y0 you have, that is y2 minus 2 y1 and plus y0. So this is equal to delta y2 minus 2 times delta y1 and plus of delta, it is y0. Write all those details individually for three values. This is delta y2, here we have written y3 minus y2 and minus of 2 times delta y1, it is y2 minus y1 plus delta y0, that is y1 minus, it is y0. If you simplify these values, you will be getting, you can verify this, 3 times of y2, first value is y3, next value is 3 times y2 minus 2 times y2 plus minus y2 is minus 3 times y2, next plus of 3 times minus minus plus 3y1 or 2y1 plus y1, 3 times y1 and minus y0, this is delta 3y0. Similarly, delta 3, it is y1 is equal to y4 minus 3 times of y3 plus 3 times of y2 and minus of
y1 are called third order forward differences.
This is the first value in third order, this is second value in third order, etc. are called third order forward differences. Third order forward differences. And so on.
Similarly, you can define fourth order, fifth order, and so on.
Let me repeat. First order forward difference is y1 minus y0. Second value in the first order forward difference is y2 minus y1, and so on. So second order forward differences, first value is delta 2y0, that is nothing but y2 minus 2y1 plus of y0, and delta 2y1 is equal to y3 minus 2y2 plus of y1, and so on. Similarly, you can define higher order differences in this way, and then you can say that these are all forward differences in the numerical analysis, that is finite differences of various orders. Let me put all these values in the form of some table later, after defining the backward differences, and then I shall conclude or I shall compare both the tables by naming them as one table as diagonal difference table and the another table as horizontal difference table.
Then similarly, we will define finite differences of various orders for backward difference. That means backward difference notation, operator notation, we will use that.
Backward differences using reverse delta.
Order of taking the differences is same.
Here we have used like, that is y1 minus y0 means next value minus of previous value. Y2 minus y1 means next value of y minus of previous value of y, like that. Similarly, here also we define, let y equal to f of x takes, the same statement you can write, takes the set of values, points or values, as x naught y naught, x1 y1, x2 y2, and so on, such that finite differences, using finite differences of various orders, using reverse delta, this is backward difference operator, or as follows, coefficients in both the definitions will be same, coefficients of the functional values like y naught y1 on the right side, y2 y1 y naught on the right side for second order, y3 y2 y1 and y0 for the third order, the coefficients will be same. For the first one, 1 comma minus 1, for the second one, 1 comma minus 2 comma plus 1, and for the third one, 1 comma minus 3 comma plus 3 and minus 1. In this order only, the notations will be changing, that means suffixes with the symbols will be different, otherwise all the values will remain to be same. Okay, so let me write according to that, the first set of values, that is reverse delta y naught. Here it is y naught minus y minus 1 and delta y1 is equal to y1 minus y naught and reverse delta y2 is equal to y2 minus y1 and so on are the, first order, backward differences. Here, what you are observing is reverse delta when it is operated on the function, that is y naught, it is nothing but f of x at x naught is equal to y naught. Then y naught minus y minus 1 means the first notation, what the suffix is there, same suffix we are going to indicate for reverse delta, that is backward difference operator. But in the case of forward difference, the last notation, the last symbol notation, whatever the suffix is there, that suffix we are going to use there. Okay, then here next is second order, delta 2 y naught is equal to, as I told you, this is 1 comma minus 1, 1 comma, this is coefficient 1 and minus 1, like this for the first order. For the second order, 1 comma minus 2 comma plus 1 we had in the forward differences, because here also simplification comes to be same. Then you can remember in this order, delta 2 y naught is equal to, this is nothing but y naught, this should be the first symbol, its previous values, that is 2 times minus 2 times y minus 1 and plus of y minus 2, 0 you start, minus 2 coefficient, its previous value minus 1, its previous value minus 2. This is the first value of second order, backward differences. Next, second value of the backward differences, that is delta 2, it is y1 is equal to y1 minus of 2 times y0 and plus y minus 1. Similarly, delta 2, it is y2 is equal to y2 minus 2 y1 and plus y0 are the, second order, second order backward differences. second order backward differences. So these are the values. Next, we'll go for third order. Delta 3 y naught reverse delta.
This is backward difference operator. When it operates on this y naught,
we are getting this backward difference operator. The first symbol is y naught. Here the order is 1 comma minus 3 comma plus 3 comma minus 1. In this order you have to write its previous value. 3 times y minus 1 plus 3 times y minus 2 and minus of this is y minus 3. And next is delta 3, it is y1. This is equal to y1. 3 times y naught plus 3 times y minus 1 and minus of this is y minus 2 etc. are called third order, it is backward differences.
Third order backward differences. So in this way you can go for other higher order differences and so on. That means when you take the operator which operates on the original function, which gives the effect according to the meaning of that operator. That operator is forward difference operator, then you will be getting next value minus of previous value with one increment. In the backward differences, like this, we go on writing the functional values. So now I will put all these values in the form of two different tables. One table is for forward differences and the another table is for backward differences. So that type of table we are going to use to solve the problems whenever set of tabulated values are given.
Table of forward differences and table of backward differences. Table of forward differences and table of backward differences. This is, for sample I am taking, only 4 values I am going to take for the sample. For both the cases, I will write in one particular direction.
You simply compare these two directions to remember how these differences, but in problems, any one of the table, but meaning of taking the differences in the from the previous column to the next column will be same.
Here another table I will write. Here also I will observe two sets of variables. One is x, another is y. X naught, x1, x2, x3. Y naught, y1, y2, y3. This is only for an example I am taking. X and y. X naught, x1, x2, x3, y naught, y1, y2, it is y3. Here forward differences means this one, delta y, delta 2y, and here up to
how many columns you have to write means it all depends on total number of paired observations.
This is one pair x0, y0, second pair x1, y1, third pair x2, y2. And the next pair is x3, y3.
Likewise, when you take, always the number of columns for the differences will be one number less.
There are totally 4 pairs are there. Up to third order difference, you have to go. that is delta 3y. This is delta y, delta 2y and delta 3y. Okay.
Now, in both the tables I will write the direction you carefully observe, and this is called one kind of type of table, and the second one is slightly different type. It is only to remember in, to apply in the problems.
Okay. So again, a screen between values, whatever so far definitions we have written, all those definitions I am putting in the form of table. Next value minus of previous value, that is y1 minus y0, is called, this one is called delta y0. Okay, next between these two, again a screen between you write y2 minus y1. So this is called delta y2, like that. Anyway, it is already written, no need of writing here. And in between these two, y3 minus y2. So whatever the next value, second order difference, first expression, this value minus of this value, this is delta y0 and this is delta y1. Delta y1 minus delta y0 is
second order difference, first value.
Therefore, this must be y2 minus 2 times y1 and plus y0. Between these two, y3 minus of 2 times y2 plus y1. And third order is nothing but difference between these two. y3, 3, y2 plus 3, y1 and plus, sorry, minus, it is y0. So this is called a forward difference table, and it has been named as diagonal difference table. This is diagonal difference table.
This is called diagonal difference table means
we consider the equation due to Newton, only these values to be substituted in the formula.
To calculate the new value from the given set of values,
we use the diagonally defined values, that means these values. Otherwise you can write top to the horizontal type, because the authors have given these two names. Let us follow the same names in order to match with the application of these tables in solving the problems.
Okay,
and here in the case of a backward difference table, instead of writing against in between, against of the second value I am going to write. That is same, procedure is same, next value minus previous value, that is y2 minus y1, y3 minus y2. Instead of writing against in between, against second value you write the value. Then second order, same, here whatever you have, same thing you will be getting, but against the second value, that is y2, 2 times y1 and plus y0. Okay, then y3 minus 2 times y2 and plus y1. This is y3, 3 times minus y2 plus 3 times y1 minus, it is y0.
Minus y0.
So here this is called a horizontal difference table. Horizontal difference table. Horizontal difference table means these values we are going to use in Newton's backward difference interpolation formula. In the case of Newton's forward interpolation formula, the top diagonal we are going to use and bottom horizontal set of values we are going to use for applying Newton's backward interpolation formula. That means when the value of x is
given in the question, the corresponding value of y is to be calculated such that if that given value of x occurs near to the beginning of the table, then we use Newton's forward interpolation formula by introducing these values. But when the given value of x appears near to the end of the table, then we use Newton's backward interpolation formula. Okay, so these two tables, you must remember, there must be clear understanding where we are using Newton's forward, Newton's backward, and with what condition. Condition is these for both one condition is that these two tables are for equally divided values. Equally divided values of x. These two tables, right? These two tables are hold good only for equally divided values. For unequally divided values, other types of interpolation formulas are there, but that is not in your syllabus. Only for equally divided, the syllabus which you are going to study in this 18 MAT DIP 41 syllabus, these two formulas only you are going to study. Now, we are going to write Newton's forward and backward interpolation formula according to these two tables, and the condition is how the value occurs near to the beginning or near to the end of the table, that we are going to verify. Now, the next heading is interpolation. The topic definition is interpolation. The very important topic, this is interpolation. Here, the meaning of this interpolation is only this much. Interpolation means inter, means in between, and collate, collate means ready. So, in between the given set of values, we have to read and then we have to record. Here, x0 and x1, for example, this number is 1 and next number is 2. In between means it may be 1.1 or it may be 1.2 or it may be 1.5 or it may be 1.87, something like that. If it is between x1 and x2, or if it is between x2 and x3, likewise, intermediate value when you are going to calculate, that is called a process of calculation of the new value by the given set of values, and from the given set of values in between, the process is called interpolation. Okay, that means you have this y equal to f of x. In both the cases, this is f of x and this is also f of x. As a result, these values, you are familiar, much familiar with these two elementary type of tables. There is some equation and then you are going to give the inputs and then you are going to calculate some new value. Therefore, interpolation is a definition. It is an art of reading. It is an art of reading between two values of x. This is one definition. Or it is the process. It is the process of obtaining. It is a process of obtaining a new value from the given set of tabulated values. From the given set of tabulated values. Already I told you that it is in between. We have to read this. Okay. Next is, what are the interpolation formulas? There are two formulas due to forward and backward that we are going to write.
we have the following.
This is as per the syllabus, it is mentioned only two formulas are to be studied for the given set of tabulated values.
We have the following interpolation formulas. One is Newton's forward interpolation formula. Newton's forward interpolation formula, and the second one, Newton's backward interpolation formula.
There are two equations you have to understand. In these two equations, we calculate a new estimation from the given set of tabulated values. So what are those equations? Those two equations we will understand one by one using the Newton's forward interpolation formula, using the operator, that is forward difference operator. This is for forward. Then this is for backward, using this reverse shape of triangle, that is called backward difference operator. Then we will use backward interpolation formula in this case, but these two formulas are meant for only when x values are equally spaced or equally divided. These two formulas are not going to be applied for unequal spacings. What do you mean by equally divided values? So equally divided values, we mean that, for example, x value and then y value. Here this is 10, 20, 30, 40 and so on. Therefore, the corresponding y values, for example, 206, this is 301 and this is 595 and then 600. Like this, give the values of y or that. First carefully observe that when you are applying these formulas, here x values are equally spaced. 10 is there, 20 is there, 10 units is the difference. 20 is there, 30 is there, 10 units is the difference. 30 is there, 40 is there, here 10 units is the difference. Therefore, it is confirmed that x values are equally divided, equally spaced. Then intermediate value we are going to calculate. For example, what is the value of y at x equal to any number? So that means y at x equal to some number. For example, here the central value is 25. 25 is the central value. Then any number comes between 25 and then after 10 is giving the interpolated value. That means y at x equal to something like 11, 12, up to 24. You can calculate using Newton's, this is called Newton's forward interpolation formula. And this is Newton's backward interpolation formula. Then any number using Newton's forward interpolation formula. If any number after this 25 and then up to 40, then we apply the second equation. So these two equations, along with some problems, I shall explain in the next lecture.